I'm on a little exploratory bicycle ride. Quite often I spend a fair amount of time searching old maps because I'm interested in the local area and what's around me, and I like to look back in history as well. And I found this website, I shared it before, where I've got a map which you can select a date, and this mapping program will go back to the 1830s, and it's got a slider so you can slide from the modern day back to the 1830s and see what was there. And so I was looking at various woodlands and various different sort of things on the map, and I came across this unusual shaped woodland. It just looked a bit odd, and so I put it on the map and I slid the slider across, and sure enough it revealed a strange anomaly. This wasn't a normal woodland. In fact, it was a church. I couldn't believe it. And it was an old church of St Mary's, which used to serve the population, a very small population, a rural population, of the hamlet of Eisey, I think Water Eaton, and a few outlying cottages. And I think there'd been a church there from the 15th century, and then the original church was demolished and a new one was built in the Victorian era, and then that one was subsequently demolished in 1953, and now it's just completely left to nature. I don't think anyone ever visits it, so it's been on my list of places to see, to go and visit in my local area. So that's what I'm going to do this evening. Just it's only a short journey, about 6.5 miles from home. So I thought I'd just pop out, have a look at it, bring you guys along as well, and just see what we can see. Be interesting to see how nature really reclaims an old churchyard.
Ready. I'm going to lift the bike over. And this is a heavy bike. That's
road and head up this farm track So we've got about a mile to go now. It's not exactly a well-defined path, shall we say. Well, yeah, not very good. That's nice. I think I'm going to push it along here. It's a bit uneven. Yeah, lovely blossom though. Hawthorn. Of course, lovely day, absolutely beautiful. It does one's soul the world of good to get out and away and out into the countryside and get some exercise and just to experience it really. It's so easy to sit at home or just let the daily grind wear you down and not actually take these precious moments and get out and experience it firsthand. So although I'd rather be riding the bike, I don't mind hiking the bike either. Works a different muscle group, and it's just such a gorgeous place to have a walk anyway, along a little lovely stream. That's the River Thames there. It flows all the way down through to London and out to sea. But this is quite at the upper reaches of the Thames, where it's very quiet and it's not such a big river. Well, it's quite a big river here, but it gets a lot bigger further on down. And just over there, there's a bridge that I've got to cross. Just there. Looks like we're on the Thames path. I must have walked across this in the past, but I can't remember it. Anyway, let's go onwards. Not much further to go now. Old Father Thames. Got to the end of the map. Don't know if you can see that. So I think there's a woodland just over the brow of the hill there, and I think that's where it is, pretty sure. So I'm not sure if I got to go through this way and along or up along this way. So anyway, we'll one way or the other we will get there. So I'm pretty sure it's that woodland over there in the far distance, about, I don't know, 300-400 yards away. Well, I do believe across the fence there is hallowed ground, God's acre. Look what's become of it. So apparently in there there's a large number of burials. There's supposed to be some graves or marked graves which you can still find. Looking at the map, the church stood over there somewhere. There's a large piece of woodland beyond, which I don't think is anything to do with the churchyard. I think this area here is all where the church was. And it's on high ground compared to the river, which runs down in the valley about 200 or 300 yards distant. So this would have been dry, high and dry, which obviously is a good thing if you're going to be burying corpses in the ground. You don't want that, the decay and the deliquescence to enter the water table, really, unless it's had a good chance to rot. So this is where it was. Let's have a look, see if we can find any graves. Okay, well, let's see if we can find anything. Pretty sure the church was over in this corner. Looks like we've got a big ditch down there. I don't reckon it's over there. I don't reckon it's through there. I reckon all the graves, I think, are all on this side. It's amazing to think that there was once a church. It stood in this exact location, and it stood there for the best part of 500 or 600 years. Can't see any yew trees, which is unusual, because you normally have yew trees when you have a church. I must say, I'm not seeing no sign of any graves yet. No. Well, I can't follow that route. That's a deer trail, that one is. Goodness knows where these graves are. Can only assume they're under all the brash. Well, I play my way through the undergrowth and I've come across tombs. Here they are, look. Graves of people. So this one is in loving memory of Ernest Willis. So he died in 1924. Doesn't look like no one's coming to pay their respects to him any longer. There's another one over here. Oh, yeah, you can see another one. So that's Charles Horton. Looks like there's one down here. So let's have a look at that. Let's look at Charles's. I think this could be a family. It's got like a thing all the way around it. Look how overgrown it is. So in loving memory of Charles James Horton, who passed away 24th of January 1947. And no doubt in amongst this, yeah, there's another one in there somewhere, look. Another one in there. So now you know what happens to churchyards when they become totally derelict and overgrown. And ultimately, everybody gets totally forgotten. Yeah, there's more. There's more. There's another one down there. They're all throughout that piece of woodland. It's Mary Evans Maslin. There's another one. There's one there. There's a large family plot by the looks of it. So it goes to show, you know, that throughout the centuries and the millennia and the thousands of years of people being born, living and dying, that there probably are corpses or skeletons or remains of people all over the place. And you're probably going out camping in the woods and not totally unaware of it, but you could well be pitched up right on top of someone's final resting place. Right, with that, I'm going to cycle off back home now. Hope you've enjoyed the video. If you have, give it a thumbs up. I'm off on a bike packing adventure, and I'll be doing that in the very next video, where you'll get to see my brand new bike, my summertime ultra lightweight bike packing bike. And it's really lightweight. I'm really dead happy with it, and it's going to allow me to do a lot more bike packing when the weather is fine and the trails are dry. So thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next one. Bye for now. Look at that. Unless you knew, you wouldn't know, would you? This was a church, and that's a churchyard.